Hey guys, this is Jon Orana and today, pag-uusapan natin paano nga ba maging chillyonaryo. Let's go. Syempre, lobat na ako. Change battery. Finally, bago na tong battery natin. Now, let's talk about paano nga ba maging chillyonaryo. But first, I will give you some brief history what happened at least to me. Nung early year of my life, first year ko pa lamang po na pagtatrabaho, I already realized the limited income and opportunities for being an employee. Because, you know, typically, alam mo na kung magkano kikitain mo, quincenas at katapusan. And in my mind, it's like, siguro there has to be somewhere out there, a way to make more money. Dahil nga po bata ka, you don't really know a lot of things when you are like in your early 20s, fresh graduate ka pa lang. You really don't know anything about life. That is the truth. So, ganun po yung nangyari sa akin. And then after working for like 8 years, you know, imagine ninyo 8 years pa ako before I can finally was able to escape the cubicle world tinatawag. The biggest, or rather one of the challenges that I had, every morning you just feel, going to work, you just feel there's something else. There's something else out there, pero hindi mo may paliwanag. Parang ganun eh, may background. Wala po kong sikretong mayaman ng mga magulang. Mga magulang ko po ay hindi nakatungtong ng kolehiyo. Wala po kong rich friends. I didn't graduate from this really big universities that are surrounded by rich kids. Wala po kong uncle na mayaman na nagbigay sa akin ng pera para magnegosyo. None of that. Every single peso sa mga negosyo ko pong pinasok, lahat po ng kapital na ipinasok ron, lahat po ay galing sa aking sweldo. Kaya po, I remember, there was one time na nag-resign po ako, I have get back pay, all these perks, lahat po yun pinangsimula ko sa negosyo. So again, wala po akong rich kids. Do not assume that maybe you become chillyonaryo. That is because you have these very successful parents behind you. I'm just telling you the entire story. Wala pong ganun. So anyway, so as what I'm saying, for many years po, I was like thinking what kind of business and what business should I start. I know that I can do more. Remember, I was like in my 20s back then. I was young. I don't have family then. One of the things that nararamdaman ko po was when I studied entrepreneurship, when I really fell in love with building business, I studied many successful entrepreneurs. I read a lot of books, read a lot of articles about them, watch many interviews. I'm that person that who really consume a lot of information, okay? I'm one of those person. That's one of my strengths. I love consuming information because I would like to see how they did it. When I start doing that, I start to also see some contradicting advices from different people. Lahat sila successful, pero minsan may pagkakaiba sila ng advice, diba? Parang ikaw mapapaisip ka, bakit ganun, right? This successful entrepreneur, sabi niya ganito daw, ito naman, sabi niya ganito, but they're all both successful. So one of the things that I saw from my own research was some people would like to start a business because they would like to become the next Mark Zuckerberg, the next Alibaba, the next Henry C, the next, you know, Tony Tan Kak Siong of Jollibee. That is their ambition. In my mind, I wasn't, nah, ha. Hindi naman talaga yun ang pangarap ko. And some of you that are listening right now, maybe you don't want to become the wealthiest person in the Philippines. Kung mangyari yun, abay, why not? Libre mo naman ako sa Starbucks. Pero I believe for most of us, hindi naman yun ang ambition natin. So yun yung mga nakikita ko, nare-realize ko na, bakit parang gano'n? Am I not dreaming big enough? Parang natatanong mo yun sa sarili mo. But then again, I was surrounded by employees. There's no one else to talk to about all these doubts and questions and fears and frustrations that I have. Wala akong mapagtanungan. And then another thing that I realized was I would like to have a business where I have more freedom. Pag sinabi kasing freedom, malawak. When you say freedom, for most people, they only think of financial freedom, which is, you know, you want to make more money, that you don't worry about money at all. And that's one of my ambition too. But at the same time, sabi ko, hindi lang freedom, but freedom of opportunities, meaning I can do other things. Not just like one business, I can have maybe multiple businesses. A freedom of relationships. Ibig sabihin, ayoko po pumasok rin sa negosyo that I have to deal with clients that are headaches, that are or partners na sakit ng ulo, that I will be forced to do things that I don't like to do, or at least against my own values, dahil lahat po tayo, whether you like it or not, we have certain beliefs and values. Another thing is yung freedom, yun nga po, to do what I love to do. Which is something that before I came up with the term chillyonaryo, it was like really in my head, but I cannot really articulate. Because when I say, I would like to have a business, but I have a business, I don't want to work 8 hours. If you tell that statement to anyone, they're gonna tell you that you are lazy, you are crazy, you are delusional, right? Pagka inaral mo ang maraming entrepreneurs, they're gonna tell you they are overworked, they work until weekends, they work this and that, and these are successful entrepreneurs. We respect them, we love them, they're gonna tell you that. I remember there was this interview ni Bill Gates, sabi niya, at ang early stage ng career niya, si Bill Gates, one of the wealthiest people in the world. It's one of my heroes, so to speak. Sasabi niya, nung early stage ng Microsoft, talagang he doesn't believe in holidays at all. No weekends, no holidays. He just like work, 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 work. Because that's what really at stake. And for him, if you really want to become successful, that's it. Ito po yung mga sinasabi ko sa inyo, like when I was new, when I was starting, there's like this contradicting. Because sa akin, hindi naman that, not because I don't want to work 8 hours, it doesn't mean that I'm lazy. It simply means that I can do something else. Whether go to the gym, play basketball for an hour, or maybe read books because I love reading books. I want to spend like at least an hour a day reading, consuming materials, or watching my YouTube videos that are empowering. Or it could be if you're spiritual, you could be if you're a Christian, you read the Bible, or whatever religion you are in, you may want to spend more time. Or I could spend more time with my kids, playing with my kids. I want to be a father. I want to be a dad. I want my kids to feel that I was there when they were growing up. So again, when I say I don't want to work 8 hours, it doesn't mean that I'm not going to do anything at all, that I'm going to watch TV for half a day. That's not the point. The point is for you to be able to do what you love to do. Whether you love painting, after you work, you only work 4 hours, now you can be able to do what you love. You love baking, you love photography, mapag-aaralan mo, you love playing guitar. You're not professional, but you're a hobbyist. You want to learn this guitar, but you know, dahil nga sa full-time job mo, ngayon nararamdaman mo na you don't have enough time. People, you can ask them, why aren't you healthy? Why are you not going to the gym? They're gonna tell you, I don't have time. So those kind of stuff, that like sa akin, again, back then, it was like muddy, maggulo, hindi mo maintindihan. It wasn't clear, foggy, muddy. I wasn't sure what kind of life I want. And then until I'd realized and be able to use it, the technology and internet, and it made me realize all these possibilities that you can finally make good money without you really working, like killing yourself. Now, the funny thing is this, once you were able to figure out this kind of business that you really enjoy and love, yung oras po lumilipad. Because that is another thing that being a chillyonaryo versus becoming an employee, you know, pag empleyado ha, you keep checking your watch, right? Hindi pa ba alas 5? Hindi pa ba lunch break? Hindi pa ba tayo matatapos sa boring meeting na to? Ano ba naman yan? Ang tagal-tagal ni boss. You know what I'm saying? But if you love, if you enjoy what you're doing, oh man, para kang bata that you're just playing. Like playing toys. Playing with your favorite toy. Remember, if you have little kids, you know this. Itong mga bata, kahit na hindi na kumain yan, makapaglaro lang. That is what it feels like when you become a chillyonaryo. Again, this is not just about income. This is about also lifestyle. Now, there are two things that I would like you to check if you really want to become a chillyonaryo. One of the biggest challenge and problem for someone why they are not making progress is this. Number one, they think that they know enough. You know what I'm saying, right? Mga tao sasabihin sa'yo, shh, alam ko na yan, ano ba naman itong video na to, John? Narinig ko na yan ilang beses na. But the thing is, narinig nila, pero hindi naman nila ina-apply. Number two is they think they don't need help. Isang tao may sakit. Kahit na available yung pinakamagaling na doktor, pinakamagaling na teknolohiya to cure that person. But if that person won't admit that he has a problem, he won't get it cured. He won't get help. That is the thing. That is a problem. Because when I talk about this, when I create videos, I can see some feedback. Some people feel it that way. And then they're wondering why they've been working so hard. Wala namang nangyayari. Hindi naman sila nakakaipon. Utang at taba lang sa katawan ang naiipon nila. So that is the thing that you would like to ask yourself. Okay? Are you humble enough to learn new things? Because the fact that you're absorbing new information, books from different sources, not just on one source. Minsan kasi, you know, we consume information just from this one category or this one group of people that we miss other opportunities na kasi mas biased ka. So that is something that is why reading books, consuming information is very important. Watching videos like this, not just my videos, watch someone else's videos, okay? If you see someone that really inspires you, watch that videos. So again, ask yourself, number one, admit that you need help. And number two is know that hindi mo alam lahat. There's no one there that knows everything. So it requires humility. And I guess that is the biggest message for this entire video, guys. So I hope this video has been really helpful for you guys. Again, thank you for watching. Wait, before you go, do not forget to click that red subscribe button below. Appreciate it. Thank you for watching.